Hey everybody, my name is Natalie Duncan-Emmons. I wanted to thank you for listening to this episode of The Morning Show. I'm the creator, the producer, and the host of the show. We want you to check out our website. It's themorningshowwithnatalie.com. You can go to that website. You can see all about our sponsors, all about the show. You can even listen to live episodes while they're going on right there from the website. Another way to listen to the show live is go to Live365. You can download that app and just search for The Morning Show. It's right there. Super easy. We want you to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel, if you will. That way you can keep up with what's going on The Morning Show. Thank you. I hope you enjoy it.
Hey, friend. It's great to have you tuned into The Morning Show today. Here on The Morning Show, you'll hear your favorite Southern gospel music and some of the classics you'll never forget. And now, the hostess of The Morning Show, Natalie Duncan-Emmons.
When you wake up to the storm and all you feel are the waves crashing against your boat, you wonder if anybody remembers you or the journey that you're on. When you feel discouraged from what you see on the news or the events going on around you, well, friend, cut it off. Don't look to the left or to the right. Look up. And when everything inside of you is screaming to be afraid, to accept defeat, or to hand our enemy a victory, well, you need to sing. And then keep singing. Sing it some more. For we are God's people. And that's just what God's people do. Well, we sing.
He said, sing from a laughing heart, just sing. When the night is dark, just sing. Let your joy explode and let music fill the air.
God sent on flashing wings to fill the sky with song. Put music in the brook and crashing seas.
The wind blew through the threads of grass like fingers through the strings of golden harps and made the meadows sing.
Then he said, sing from a laughing heart, just sing. When the night is dark, just sing. Let your joy explode.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all.
Then he said, sing from a laughing heart, just sing. When the night is dark, just sing. Let your joy explode and let music fill the air.
You can sing
when there's nothing else to do. Sing
Consider circumstances growing out of control. Do you debate your dilemmas? Speculate on the outcomes. It can sure weigh heavy on your soul.
But if you'll think about
no more fears in a land where tears are forever wiped away. If you'll think about going home and the joy you'll know seeing Jesus face to face. Your fear of the future fades when you're sure there's a hope beyond compare. It'll really help you live down here though trouble's coming near. If you'll think about that.
On the new song, rising out of heaven and the glory we will share. Instead of bogging down in humdrum, chart a course for the kingdom. It'll do you so much good to think about there. Cause if you'll think about
no more fears in a land where tears are forever wiped away. If you'll think about going home and the joy you'll know seeing Jesus face to face. Your fear of the future fades when you're sure there's a hope beyond compare. It'll really help you live down here though trouble's coming near. If you think about there.
So friend, keep looking up.
Set your mind on things above.
If you'll think about
sure there's a hope beyond compare. It'll really help you live down here though trouble's coming near.
It'll really help you live down here though trouble's coming near.
If you'll think about
my name is Natalie Duncan-Emmons. You are listening to The Morning Show. Ran across this yesterday. I thought it was worth passing on to you. It seems pretty fitting for the day that we live in. It says, first we overlook evil, then we permit evil, and then we legalize evil, then we promote evil, then we celebrate evil, and then we persecute those who still call it evil. Isaiah 5:20 says, woe unto them who call evil good and good evil. I hope we never get crisscrossed with what is evil and what is good. May we always take a stand for the right thing. I'm glad you're listening to The Morning Show. There is no other place I'd rather be than right here with you. Here's the Right Road Quartet.
I have decided I'm gonna live like a believer. Turn my back on the deceiver. I'm gonna live what I believe. I have decided being good is just a fable. I just can't cause I'm not able. I'm gonna leave it to the Lord. I have decided I'm gonna live like a believer. Turn my back on the deceiver. I'm gonna live what I believe. I have decided being good is just a fable. I just can't cause I'm not able. I'm gonna leave it to the Lord.
There's a wealth of things that I profess, said that I believe. Deep inside I never changed. I guess I'd been deceived. Cause a voice inside kept telling me that I'd change by and by. But the Spirit made it clear to me that kind of life's a lie.
I have decided I'm gonna live like a believer. Turn my back on the deceiver. I'm gonna live what I believe. I have decided being good is just a fable. I just can't cause I'm not able. I'm gonna leave.
Jesus brings. And when the world begins to see you change, don't expect them to applaud. Keep your eyes on him and tell yourself, I've become the work of God.
I have decided I'm gonna live like a believer. Turn my back on the deceiver. I'm gonna live what I believe. I have decided being good is just a fable. I just can't cause I'm not able. I'm gonna leave it to the Lord. I have decided I'm gonna live like a believer. Turn my back on the deceiver. I'm gonna live what I believe.
I have decided
being good is just a fable. I just can't cause I'm not able. I'm gonna leave it to the Lord. I have decided I'm gonna live like a believer. Turn my back on the deceiver. I'm gonna live what I believe. I have decided the fable. I just can't cause I'm not able. I'm gonna leave it to the Lord. I have decided.
There, it's super easy to find. If you go to YouTube and simply search The Morning Show and put my name, Natalie Duncan-Emmons, well, it will pop right up. We would sure appreciate it if you would subscribe to that channel. That way you are notified every time we put something new out. If you miss an episode, if you miss an interview, well, we always put those out there. Almost every single episode that we produce will be on that YouTube channel, and every interview that we have on this show will go to the YouTube channel. I do have people ask me occasionally about a certain episode that they are looking for that is not on the YouTube channel, and I just wanted to give a brief explanation as to why a few of them are not out there. And that really has nothing to do with us. We attempt to put every episode out there on the channel, but occasionally YouTube will block us. They don't give us an explanation why. They simply say something in that show has a block on it. It can be a song. It can be something that we talked about. We don't know. And that is beyond our control. So if you are looking for a specific episode and cannot find it, well, chances are YouTube blocked us from posting that episode. We attempt to put every single one out there. We give it all we've got. Sometimes they give us a little bit of a hard time. So there have been a few that they blocked. Not a whole lot, but there have been a few. So if you've been looking for one and can't find it, well, there you go. That might explain it for you. But we appreciate you supporting the YouTube channel. We want you to subscribe to it, and that way you'll always know when something new comes out. We appreciate you.
I'm gonna love like I'm leaving. Give more than I'm receiving. Laugh until it takes my breath away. I'm gonna say what needs saying, pray what needs praying. I'm gonna love like I'm leaving today. I'm gonna love like I'm leaving. Give more than I'm receiving. Laugh until it takes my breath away. Listen like I mean it. Spend a little more time. Woo! For the ones I love longer. Slow down and unwind. Gonna smile at a stranger. Maybe make a new friend. Before the day is done, gonna dance in the sun and soak it all in. I'm gonna love like I'm leaving. I'm gonna say what needs saying, pray what needs praying. I'm gonna love like I'm leaving today.
Gonna mend a few fences,
go the extra mile, lend a hand where it's needed.
Sit down and talk for a while. Take a stroll on a Sunday.
long walk in the park. I'm not gonna miss one thing on the list
when it comes to the heart.
I'm gonna love,
boom, boom, boom.
Love like I'm leaving, give more than I'm receiving, laugh until it takes my breath away. I'm gonna say what needs saying, pray what needs praying. I'm gonna love like I'm leaving today. I'm gonna love like I'm leaving, give more than I'm receiving, laugh until it takes my breath away.
I had to pass this information along because you're going to want to take advantage of this. These are, well, pretty much once in a lifetime deals. Today, I want to tell you about the Children's Bible Story pillows. You can get them in a pack of five. If you have a lot of grandkids, if you have nieces and nephews, if you want to get these as Christmas presents and go ahead and put them up, that's very smart. The five pack is normally $199.90. That's basically $200. You can normally get five pillows for $200. Today, and for a short time only, with the promo code Natalie, you can get a five pack of these Children's Bible Story pillows. Are you ready? For $39.99. Normally, you can't buy one of these pillows for $39.99. You can now get a five pack. I would suggest you get them, you put them up for Christmas presents, for birthday presents. It's too good a deal to pass up. That's simply what this is. Go out to mypillow.com today. First thing when you get there is put the promo code Natalie in, and then you will see your discounted sales. You'll never get this opportunity again. MyPillow.com. Use the promo code Natalie.
Alas, and did my Savior bleed, and did my sovereign die? Sacred head for sinners such as I. Was it for crimes that I had done? He groaned upon the tree. Amazing pity, grace alone, and love beyond. At the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Appears, tears off my heart. was at the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. And now I am happy all the day.
Music, ministry, and more. It's The Morning Show with Natalie Duncan-Emmons.
You're listening to The Morning Show. And now, with your patriotic point of view, here's Larry Gresset.
Kelloggs is the leading American producer of ready-to-eat cereals and other food products. Kelloggs Corn Flakes was one of the earliest and remains one of the most popular breakfast cereals in the United States. They're headquartered in Battle Creek, Michigan. The company was founded as the Sanitas Food Company in 1900 by the brothers W.K. Kellogg and Dr. John H. Kellogg, who together had developed a method of producing crunchy, flavorful flakes of processed grain that proved a popular breakfast food among the patients at Dr. Kellogg's Battle Creek Sanitarium. W.K. Kellogg eventually bought out his brother and in 1906 established the Battle Creek Toasted Corn Flake Company. Through innovative advertising techniques and improvements in the quality of the cereal, the company prospered. The present name was adopted in 1922 after the company began making cereals other than cornflakes. In 1969, the company began to diversify. The acquisition of Salada Foods that year introduced tea and desserts to its product line. It purchased Fern International, makers of soups, sauces, and other foods in 1970. Mrs. Smith's Pie Company in 1976, and Pure Packed Foods, makers of non-dairy frozen foods in 1977. By the beginning of the 21st century, Kellogg had refocused its product lines into categories that included ready-to-eat cereals, convenience and snack foods such as granola bars, cookies and cracker products, many of which acquired through its purchase of Keebler Foods in 2001, and frozen breakfast foods. Kellogg's sales regions now cover North America, Europe, Latin America, Asia, and Australia. But it all started right here in the U.S. of A. I'm Larry Gresset with your patriotic point of view.
The patriotic point of view was brought to you by Joe McGee Construction. Joe McGee Construction believes family is one of God's greatest gifts. Family owned and operated for the past 33 years, Joe McGee Construction is the proud employer of some of Mississippi's best tradesmen. Together, we are supporting our communities and working hard to ensure that every commute to work and every ride to school brings us safely home to our loved ones. Valuing faith, family, and the Magnolia State, Joe McGee Construction is building safer roads for a better Mississippi. Joe McGee is my friend, and I thank him for helping us bring you the best mix of Southern gospel music, along with your patriotic point of view here on The Morning Show.
Come on, come on, come on.
In this house,
oh well, why don't you
come on?
house,
yeah. Why don't you
come on in this house? Come on in this house of the Lord.
You know we're seeking soul salvation.
Come on in this house.
Well, we're seeking soul salvation.
Come on in this house, yeah.
Seeking soul salvation.
Come on in this house. Come on in this house of the Lord.
Jesus said to Peter, on this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against the rock that availeth much.
In every city I'll build a church, on a solid rock it'll stand, and I'll say,
shelter,
listen children,
go and come again.
You got a standing invitation
to my Father's house.
Oh, standing invitation
to my Father's house,
yeah.
Standing invitation
to my Father's house. Come on in this house of the Lord. Come and go with me to my Father's house, to my Father's house. Come and go with me to my Father's house, to my Father's house. There's peace and joy and love, there's victory from above. Come and go with me to my Father's house, to my Father's house.
Just released yesterday from Darren and Brooke Aldridge. It's called Jordan.
Oh, coming as you tread life's journey, take Jesus as your daily guide. Though you may feel pure and safely without him walking by your side. But when you come to make the crossing at the ending of your pilgrim's way, if you ever will meet our Savior, you'll surely meet him on that day.
Look at that
cold Jordan.
Look at these
deep waters.
Look at that
wide river. Oh, hear the mighty billows roll.
You better take
Jesus with you.
He's a
true companion
for a
sure without him that you never will make me
my Lord, have you heard about Nancy Pelosi ridiculing the Archbishop in San Francisco? Former House Speaker Nancy Pelosi publicly rebuked Archbishop Salvatore Cardellione, saying that his decision to bar her from receiving Holy Communion was his problem, not hers. She criticized him for not supporting the LGBT causes and for opposing abortion. Pelosi was speaking at an event in Georgetown University's Center on Faith and Justice. It was part of their Higher Calling series, and it focused on the faith of politicians. The March the 23rd event was moderated by Jim Wallace, a progressive Christian and the center's executive director. Now, in May of 2022, Cordelione, that's the Archbishop, he issued a letter announcing that Pelosi would be barred from communion in churches under his purview due to her stance on abortion. Pelosi has long been an advocate for abortion rights, and that position is, well, it's in direct contrast with the teachings of the Catholic Church. So she's quoted as saying, "I have a problem with my Archbishop, and I figure that's his problem, not mine." That's what she said at the event. Now, here's my point in all of this, or my question in all of this. Why in the world is Nancy Pelosi speaking at an event on faith? Why would Mr. Wallace, who is an active Christian and the center's executive director, ask Miss Nancy Pelosi to come speak at such an event? She should have been barred from that. That's my opinion only. Here's Cece.
I've got joy in the struggle. I've got peace in the storm. I've got strength in the battle. I don't fear anymore. I'm a child of heaven, and my hope is secure. I've got joy, 'cause I've got Jesus. He gave me beauty for ashes, turned my life around. He broke my chains, and now I dance on solid ground. For all he's done to save me, I will raise my voice. I've got Jesus, so I've got joy. He bore all
don't remember the day, and I don't remember the place, and I don't remember the words that were said, but I changed. Oh, I changed, and I don't remember the years. I don't remember the tears. Oh, I don't remember the pain that it took me to see. But now I see. Trusting and learning, patient and loving. At least I am becoming. I don't remember mistakes, no. And I don't remember heartaches. Oh, trusting and learning, patient and loving. At least I am becoming. I will remember your name, and I
for grass-fed beef that's USDA certified, look no further than our friends at J&L Farms. J&L Farms raises 100% grass-fed beef with no additives. J&L Farms sells steaks, ribeye, sirloins, New York strip, or any of your favorite steak cuts. They also sell roast, hamburger meat, any kind of specialty beef you want, they can get it done for you. Grass-fed beef is a healthy choice because it's leaner and has significantly lower levels of saturated fat.
It's also higher in vitamins and antioxidants. It's simply a healthier choice for your body. So for special pricing or request, pick up locations, you need to call our friend Larry Mathis at J&L Farms at 601-917-8063. That's 601-917-8063. Be good to your heart. Make the healthy choice. Choose delicious, grass-fed beef from J&L Farms.
Here to let the world know God's got a song, and it is the song of salvation through Jesus Christ and Him alone. And we will sing this song and we will play this song as long as we have breath in these bodies. And then the Lord will give us a new song, a song that only the redeemed can sing. And we will sing that song through all of eternity. My name is Natalie Duncan-Emmons, and you are listening to The Morning Show.
Well, our friends from Michigan, the Justified Quartet, they are celebrating great, great success
with their song, Turn Your Back. I told you they would. I told you they would. Here's Mark Jacoby now.
We're excited about what's happening with Turn Your Back. And of course, the message is, right, it's perfect because basically what it's saying is turn your back on all the negative, on the people that are negative about you, about the situation you're in, whatever it is. Be positive about Christ, right? And so the message is there, but the style, this is something different. And for Justified, something different as well.
I marked this one. I predicted it. I told them it'd be their first number one song. It's number one on a lot of charts. We'll see what it does for the singing news. Here they are. It's Tim Caldwell. That's what it is. Just listen at it.
If you're tired of the life you're living, if you're taking more than you've been giving, if your life seems a little more lonely every day, you for what you are.
Well, I want to talk to you about the good folks over at Hometown Roots in Sebastopol, Mississippi. It is not too late to get your Easter decor or all of your Easter needs from Hometown Roots. I am looking on the fake book right now. I'm looking at an Easter yard flag that is absolutely beautiful. I love to ride by somebody's house and see a yard flag. I think they are beautiful. I need one. They have Easter yard flags. They have Easter jewelry that would be beautiful with your Easter outfit Sunday morning. And it's Jennifer Timms. And you know you cannot beat Jennifer Timms jewelry. Those are just a couple of items that they have. They have decorations. They have baskets for your children. They have anything that you can need for Easter. Well, I guarantee you that Kitty Ladner can help you with whatever you need for your Easter decorations or your flowers for Easter or your gifts for Easter. You need to go over to Hometown Roots. That's where I go for everything that I need. And I wish you would do the same thing because they help to bring you the morning show every single day. 601-625-7512 for all your Easter.
Music, ministry, and more. It's The Morning Show with Natalie Duncan-Emmons.
You're listening to The Morning Show, and here's your pastor's perspective brought to you today by Brother Doug Payne from Hanger Church, Brandon, Mississippi.
John 17, verse 20 and 21. My prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who will believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one, Father, just as you are in me and I am in you. Our youth just went through a youth weekend called D-Now. The theme this year was to abide. Last Wednesday night, I was talking to them and asked them what the word abide meant to them. One said it's where you live, your home. Another said it's where you stay. And the biblical meaning of abide is to stay or to remain there. Right before Jesus went to the cross, he prayed for what was about to happen to him, and he prayed for the disciples, and then he prayed for all of us, the ones who would become believers. His prayer was that we would all be one, as he and the Father are one. For all of us to be one, we must abide in his love. We must love like Christ. Our youth group is multiracial and from different economic statuses. But they are one. They love each other without exception. 1 John 4:12 says, if we love one another, God abides in us and his love has been perfected in us. As we approach Easter, may our love truly be perfected. This is Doug Payne with your pastor's perspective.
The pastor's perspective was brought to you by Salem Baptist Church in Lake, Mississippi. Salem is my home church, and I'm thrilled that they've partnered with The Morning Show to help us bring you, well, not only the best music in the world, but encouragement and words of life straight from God's Word. Brother Larry Duncan and the entire congregation at Salem, they invite you to come and visit whenever you get the chance. We're located just a few miles off of I-20 coming through mid-Mississippi. So if you live in our area, if you're ever traveling through our area on a Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night, well, you stop off the lake exit and visit with us. Thank you to Salem Baptist Church for bringing you your pastor. We have been playing it hot and heavy ever since it was released. It's one of my favorites. Clint Brown wrote that. He had something pretty special to say.
God all along knew where we were. You know, we call ourselves lost, you know, but the truth of the matter is we were just separated at the garden from him. But he knew where we were the whole time. And so when Jesus came and died on the cross, all that was him going to the lost and found and reclaiming what was already his.
Clint Brown was sick on Friday night, a night to remember. He didn't get to sing this one, but Seth stepped in and did a pretty terrific job. Clint is feeling better, by the way, if you have been wondering about him. You're southbound.
I won't forget the night I stepped out of my pew, walked down the aisle, my running days were through. I knelt at the altar just as I am, gave my life to the Father and left a brand new man. and I was baptized. He washed my dark soul like snow made it white. I lifted these two hands, no longer bound. For the first time I stood cleansed and able to shout.
When life feels hard and life gets tough, he tells me I am enough, and this world can never knock me off my feet. Jesus and me. It's always Jesus and me.
Well, on a personal note, for the record, I am disappointed and infuriated by what has been concocted by the far left manipulators, the liberals, the fake media, and the entire Democratic Party against our former president, Donald J. Trump. I will refrain from personal commentary, but I will read you what Franklin Graham said on his Facebook page yesterday. Here's a quote. "Under our nation's constitution, you and I are innocent of a crime unless and until we are proven guilty. This fundamental right applies to every American, from the immigrant who becomes a newly natural citizen, to those who have served in the highest office of the land. And our process of justice is intended to operate independent of partisan political calculation. Partisan political calculation, however, appears to be precisely the motivation behind the indictment of former President Donald J. Trump in a Manhattan courtroom. It's saddening to see what left-wing politicians are doing to our country. Be sure, though, that the judge of all the earth, Almighty God, will do what is just." Genesis 18:25. "Before him, each and every one of us is a sinner deserving death. That's why this is the moment to make sure that when the judge examines your life, you have placed your faith in Jesus Christ's death and resurrection for the forgiveness of your sins." Well said, Brother Graham. Well said. Well said. Don't you ever think this is not about politics. It's only about politics.
I know there's gonna be some brighter days. I swear that love will find you in your pain. I feel it in me like the beating of life in my veins. I know there's gonna be some brighter days. I know there's gonna be some brighter days. Oh, ashes fall from burning dreams. Oh, never live through times like these. Trying hard to breathe in the dark, in the dark. I know there's gonna be some brighter days.
Yes, sir.
I swear that love will find you in your pain. I feel
there's gonna be some brighter days. I swear that love will find you in your pain. I feel it in me like the beating of life in my veins. Oh, I know there's gonna be some brighter days. Oh, I swear that love will find you in your pain. I feel it in me like the beating of life in my veins. I know there's gonna be some brighter days. I know there's gonna be some brighter days. I know there's gonna be some brighter days.
Well, got old Nicodemus, got old Nicodemus.
God said, yes, he did.
He told Nicodemus, man, you must be born again. Well, God told Nicodemus, God told Nicodemus.
God said, yes, he did.
He told Nicodemus, man, you must be born again. Well, there was a man of the Pharisees by the name of Nicodemus. He did not believe. Same Nicodemus came to God by night, talking about religion from the human side. He brought along his silver, diamonds, and gold to buy his way to heaven and save his soul. But God told Nicodemus, God told Nicodemus.
God said, yes, he did.
He told Nicodemus, man, you must be born again. Well, God told Nicodemus, God told Nicodemus.
God said, yes, he did.
He told Nicodemus, man, you must be born again. Well, old Nicodemus came a-running hard, said, has anybody here done seen the Lord? Wanna buy some religion, what will it cost to get into heaven for my soul be lost? That my God spoke and he spoke so sweet, sounding like a shuffle of angels' feet. He said, marvel them, man, if you wanna be wise, you got to believe and be baptized. Then God told Nicodemus, God told Nicodemus.
God said, yes, he did.
He told Nicodemus, man, you must be born again. Well, God told Nicodemus, God told Nicodemus.
God said, yes, he did.
He told Nicodemus, man, you must be born again. Well, old Nicodemus was taken back, cause God done told him about the natural fact. Said, marvel thou, man, if you want to be wise, you got to believe and be baptized. Still, old Nicodemus was taken back, cause God done told him about the natural fact. Said, I don't understand, I want to know, how can a man be born when he's old? Then my God spoke and his voice did ring, sounding like a shuffle of angels' wings. He said, marvel thou, man, if you want to be wise, you got to believe and be baptized. Then God told Nicodemus,
God told Nicodemus. God said, yes, he did.
He told Nicodemus, man, you must be born again. Well, God told Nicodemus, God told Nicodemus.
God said, yes, he did.
He told Nicodemus, man, you must be born again.
Ladies, have y'all heard that shoulder pads are coming back? Can you believe that? They're wearing them at the Oscars. They're wearing them in fashion shows. They're wearing outfits that have big shoulder pads and making their picture and putting them on Instagram and Facebook. Can you believe that? I thought that was gone forever. It's not. Shoulder pads are coming back, so just brace yourself. I dread to see it, but now, this is Lauren Talley. This is Kenna Turner West, and this is Amber Saunders with 11th Hour. Those three ladies have made a trio. This is them.
He didn't do anything wrong but pray three times a day, but still Daniel kept the faith. And the three Hebrew boys wouldn't buy. No way, no how, there was no backing down. They were willing to lay down their lives, but God in his goodness delivered right on time. He's the God who shuts the mouths of lions. He's the God stands in the flame. with a choice to be made. Will you stand for the Lord faithfully, or to the world bow a knee? Oh, what will it be? Will you live for to work a miracle? What he did back then, he'll do again. He's the God who shuts the mouths of lions. Oh, he's the God who stands in the
ministry and more. It's the Morning Show with Natalie Duncan-Emmons.
This story I am about to tell you, the inspiration comes to me from the Lieutenant Governor of the great state of Georgia, Mr. Zell Miller. That's right. I grew up at Route 4, Liberty, Mississippi. The county seat town was a small town, volunteer fire department. It was in the middle of the summer, big drought, no water. Everybody knew if a building caught on fire, it was gone, because there wasn't no water. They just couldn't draw it up fast enough to put out no fire. One Saturday evening, a building caught on fire, commenced to burning. The crowd gathered with their arms folded, squalling, watching the building burn, cause there ain't no water. About that time, here come Uncle Versy Ledbetter and Aunt Pet in the old truck. Had all of the young'uns with them. Ardell, Burnell, Raynell, W.L., Linnell, Odell, Udell, Marcel, Claude, Eugene, and Clovis is all hanging on that old truck. Everybody heard them coming, the fenders rattling. Blop, 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 blop. Here they come. And the crowd parted because they was coming pretty fast. And they run right on up on the sidewalk and right up in the middle of the fire. Into the fire, and it jumped off and took off the overhaul jumpers and went to flopping and stomping the fire. Whoa, putting it out. Aunt Pet Ledbetter had her bonnet telling them, ho, stomp over him, get it out. Wah, wah. And they stomped the fire out. They put it slap out. The folks cheered. Ah! The Ledbetters, they're heroes. They put out the fire. They passed a hat, took up a collection. Took up $31. Give the money to Uncle Versy. Said, sir, we love you. You are a hero. Said, tell us, what you gonna buy with the $31? He said, the first thing I'm gonna do is get the brakes fixed on that truck.
John G. Weatherford Incorporated. Well, they're proud to be connected to the morning show. They're known to most as Weatherford Oil. They're a third-generation owned and operated family business that values God, family, employees, and customers. For over 40 years, they've been providing diesel, gasoline, motor oil, hydraulic fluid, grease, and logging supplies to some of Mississippi's best loggers, farmers, chicken growers, land managers, municipalities, individuals, and convenience stores. Whether you need large or small quantities, well, they'd love the opportunity to talk to you about supplying all of your fuel and oil needs. With two locations, they proudly serve Scott, Lauderdale, Newton, Smith, Neshoba, Jasper, Clark, Kemper, Rankin, and Leake counties. If you appreciate Weatherford Oil helping to bring you the morning show, well, we would appreciate it if you'd call John at Meridian, 601-693-0981, 601-693-0981, or Jason in Forest, 601-469-3931, that's 601-469-3931, and let them take care of all of your fuel and oil needs. We appreciate them. We appreciate you.
Must have been like to be Noah, building a boat in the desert long before it ever rained. Or can you imagine how it must have felt to be walking in circles with Jericho there before you, with walls standing in the way? How do ordinary people do extraordinary things? Just believe God will make a way. Believe, then take a step of faith to see the Lord do what looks like an impossibility. All you gotta do is just believe. La da 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 da. La da 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 da. Imagine being stuck in a boat in stormy weather like Peter, stepping out on the water, no matter about the wind and waves. What it must have been like to be Mary and Martha, standing at the grave of their brother, while the stone was rolled away. Miracles still happen for folks like you. Step of faith to see the Lord do what looks like an impossibility. All you gotta do is just believe.
Step of faith.
My name is Natalie Duncan-Emmons. You're listening to The Morning Show. Here on The Morning Show, we're looking for the very best mix of gospel music, predominantly Southern gospel with a little bit of bluegrass, a little bit of Christian country, contemporary, and inspirational. The mixture of different styles and genres here on The Morning Show is a musical picture of the diversity of the Bride of Christ. Though every style is different, the message we play is the same. The gospel of Jesus Christ and salvation through Him alone. For worthy is the Lamb who was slain. My name's Natalie Duncan-Emmons. Glad you're listening to The Morning Show.
I know what the devil looks like. He's one more shot of bourbon after midnight. He's a red dress that don't know right from wrong. And he's a bad choice dancing with a song. I know where the devil likes to walk. On hot coals down dingy hotel halls and memory lanes to dig up what you did wrong. That's where the devil likes to walk. And I guess you could call him a prophet, 'cause he'll show you all your sins and he'll scare you straight as whiskey if you get too close to him. Sometimes you find the light running from your demons. That's how the devil led me to Jesus. I know why the devil never sleeps, 'cause he loves to talk you right out of your dreams. But he probably should have left well enough alone while that Bible on the dresser was still closed. And I guess you could call him a prophet, 'cause he'll show you all your sins. He's a beautiful fire till the pain starts setting in. Yeah, sometimes you find the light running from demons. And that's how the devil led me to Jesus. I had nowhere left to turn, so I really had no choice but to fall down on my knees and cry out to the Lord. Yeah, sometimes you find the light running from your demons. I had to put a whole lot of distance in between us. That's how the devil led me to Jesus.
Well, this is just an awful sad story. It brings me no joy to bring this, but it's happened. It's happened, and it's made, well, worldwide news, so I'm going to bring it to you. In Beaver Creek, Ohio, there's an outdoor mall. It's the center of the community, really. It's called the Greentown Center. They were trying to do something nice for the community. They really were. They planned a big Easter egg hunt. They had businesses to donate gifts and prizes for the winners. They really put a lot into it. But on a Facebook post, the Greentown Center management wrote that, unfortunately, the event did not turn out as they had hoped and planned for. They continued to write that the event was meant to allow 1 and 2 year olds to hunt for eggs in a designated area, followed by 3 and 4 year olds to begin hunting elsewhere with their parents with a 60 second head start ahead of everyone else. And then everyone else could begin their hunt. Now, only children were supposed to pick up the eggs. And the post said that management spent almost an hour giving out these instructions because no one would listen. And it wasn't so much the kids, it was the adults. Problems with crowd control began immediately. They said the parents would not even listen to requests to move to one area for instructions. They were trying to get everybody together to give the instructions of the hunt. The parents wouldn't even listen to that. Then when the 1 and 2 year olds were allowed to begin their hunt of their eggs, well, some parents ran to the grassy area that was for the 1 and 2 year olds, and they began hunting the eggs, literally pushing the little children out of the way. The Post added that many adults were seen picking up eggs. That was against the rules. It was only for the little children to pick up the eggs. And that many adults continued to knock children over, leaving several children empty-handed. So when the hunt was completed, many of the children had no eggs to show, but many adults had several eggs, lots of eggs. The manager of the event said it was absolutely unacceptable behavior, and they apologized to anyone who was affected by these selfish actions. They ended the post by thanking those who donated prizes and their time to help with the event. They went on to announce that that would be the last Easter egg hunt. They said, "We're not doing this anymore. If you can't act right, we will not have it." Next year, the Green Town Center plans to hold a prize raffle with one ticket per child for Easter instead of an Easter egg hunt. So that way they can keep it fair, I guess. Each child gets a ticket and they'll just draw one child to win. Isn't that sad? Isn't that incredibly sad? It's an Easter egg hunt. And most of the trouble was not with the kids, it was with the parents. Does that really surprise you? 601-616-4066, 601-616-4066. I would love your opinion on the matter.
We have come too far to turn back now. There's an end inside we see. And the Lord has brought us safe thus far with His grace and perfect peace. But too many battles have been lost with the finish line in sight. So let us keep the faith and win this race before the day turns into night. No time to rest a while. When you're halfway to your victory, you must go that extra mile. Just keep pressing on, though the road is long. When your feet get tired, still you must walk on. Oh, when you're halfway up the mountain, just keep climbing. So let us just keep traveling on. When you're halfway up the mountain, there's no time to rest a while. When you're halfway to your victory, you must go that extra mile. Just keep pressing on, though the road is long. When your feet get tired, still you must walk on. Oh, when you're
folks. We're Tribute Quartet.
And you're listening to
The Morning Show with Natalie.
One dark night in Egypt, a fearful time had come for one little Hebrew boy who was his father's firstborn son. Now with the angel of death passing low, it was hard to fall asleep. But one little lamp stood in his mind as he lay there counting sheep. He wondered why the young lamb had to die, why his blood was on the door. Through the wind and rain, it still remained, but he wanted. So he called out to his earthly father with a trembling voice so scared, crying, "Father, will you please look and see if the blood is still there?" He said, "Son, now don't you worry, for the blood is there to stay. Wash away. The blood will stand the raging storm. It's been applied with loving care. Safe, secured, you can rest assured that the blood is still there." Looking over the damage Satan's storm had left behind, the flood of endless questions and doubt had filled my mind. The fear that gripped my troubled soul brought me back to my knees in prayer, crying, "Father, will you please look and see if the
say a word about the sweets and Star C Sweets Catering. I've told you they make any kind of cake you want, and it'll be too pretty to even cut. I'll guarantee you that. They have cupcakes, pedophores, the different kinds of breads, cookies, and well, I can't make a commercial for Star C Sweets without mentioning the Oreo balls because they are my favorites. But I'm not sure I've ever told you about Star C Sweets cookie cakes. They're absolutely perfect for any occasion or party, or maybe you've just got a sweet tooth and want something special for that. You've got to try one of these cookie cakes from Star C Sweets. Heather Compton can decorate it any way that you want it. It's the natural choice for your next birthday party or family get together. I promise it will be a hit. So send Heather a message today on the fake book. You can look them up, Star C Sweets, or you can give her a call today if that's easier. 601-900-0214. That's 601-900-0214. We're just asking you to support Star C Sweets because they help bring you the morning show every single day. Get you one of those cookie cakes.
chosen, his body would be broken, but he would surely rise from the dead. He did it like he said it, and then when he ascended, he promised he'd be coming back again.
He didn't stay dead, and he won't stay gone.
Trusting and awaiting, watching and praying, 'cause I believe it's gonna be soon.
He didn't stay dead and he won't stay gone. He'll roll back the clouds like he rolled back the stone. If you trust his word, rest assured you can't go wrong. 'Cause he didn't stay dead and he won't stay gone.
I need to tell you something pretty important now before we go, because I just realized I haven't told you this at all. We will be having Throwback Thursday tomorrow, and this is a big one. This is a big one. We all know the song Midnight Cry. You know it as well as you know your name. Well, Mr. Chuck Day, the writer of Midnight Cry, he and his brother Greg Day, they wrote that song. Chuck Day will be right here on the morning show tomorrow to tell us all about writing Midnight Cry. How about that? Talk about a throwback Thursday. Won't that be a throwback? So don't miss Chuck Day. You'll hear all about Midnight Cry right here tomorrow. Have a good one. See you later.
I hated to awake. He dreamt he was an angel at the great pearly gates.
St. Peter said, "Why, hello there. Where have you been?"
"I've got your mansion ready, so come right in.
I need a ring for an angel to act as a guide."
He spread his wings a time or two and learned how to fly.
Oh, it's a great, great morning. Your first day in heaven when you stroll down the golden avenue. There are mansions left and right.
Stay in heaven when you realize your worried days are through.
been listening to The Morning Show with Natalie Duncan-Emmons. We're glad you joined us. We want to invite you back tomorrow when once again you'll hear some of the very best in gospel music and some of the finest in Christian entertainment. Will you join us tomorrow? Is it a date? We'll look for you then. God bless and goodbye, everybody.